In previous classes, we discussed about the political causes in which as doctrine of lapse, subsidiary alliance, direct military confrontations, how does the responsible for the distress among the Indians, then as economic causes includes as the ruined the Indian industry to the industrialization introduced by the Britishers, second land revenue systems, third introduction of a commercial crops, cash crops, which led to the deprived the economic conditions of farmers. Then we discuss about the socio-religious causes, such social and religious reforms which done by the Britishers during the colonial period, how they adversely impact on the life of the people. Now as the military causes. Military causes. The highest rank which was offered, which was given to the highest rank given to the, am I audible? So the highest rank given to the Indians, it was as the Subedar by the Britishers. This was as a discrimination. Indians, for their braveries, they were not awarded with the higher ranks. Second one, the Indian sepoys were looked upon an inferior being. The Indian sepoys, they were looked upon as inferior beings and treated badly by their British superiors. Foreign Services Alliance, which earlier given to the such Indian sepoys or soldiers, which were represented Britishers in war front. Third, they were paid much less than British soldiers. Indian soldiers, they were paid less than, much less than much less than as compared to British soldiers. Fourth, Indian soldiers who formed more than 85% of the total British army. Indian soldiers who formed more than 85% of the total British army in India, they were suffered with oppressive British rule. They were suffered with oppressive British rule. Next one, fifth, being a part of Indian society, the Indian sepoys were forbidden to wear caste to wear caste marks like tilak or beard, like tilak or beard. Clear? These were the military causes. Now, as the immediate cause means that incident which led to the outbreak of revolt. Immediate cause. Which incident which led to the outbreak, the beginning of revolt? All these were the causes responsible to make as the framework for the revolt. But that incident, it responsible to spark the fire of a revolt in India. It responsible for the beginning of a revolt. The revolt of 1857 began by the reaction of company officers, to the controversy over, the ammunitions for the new Enfield pattern rifle. Britishers introduced the new Enfield rifle. Enfield rifle. It was related with the ammunition for the new Enfield rifle. This rifle, introduced in British Army in 1853, the greased cartridges, cartridges means bullets, for these rifles had to be bitten off before being inserted into the rifle. Means before filling the bullet into the rifle, the soldier, it should remove that particular cap which occurred on such bullets. Bullets were covered with a material which should remove with the mouth and fill the bullet in rifle. So I'm repeating again, the greased cartridges for these rifles had to be bitten off before being inserted into the rifle. Rumors had spread in the sipoys' camps that the grease contained fat from pigs and cows. The grease means that material which surrounded the bullet. The grease contained fat from pigs and cows. And the Hindus and Muslim sipoys, they objected to using them. They object against such cartridges which were introduced by the Britishers in British Army. So in this process, the first martyr of 1857, first martyr, the first person which refused to use greased cartridges, the first person which refused to use greased cartridges and sacrifice himself, or the first martyr of 1857, it was Mangal Pandey. It was Mangal Pandey. He killed three British officials. In such evas, the Britishers, they hanged him. Unhe phansi de di gayi thi. It was as a first martyr of a revolt of 1857, which refused to use of a greased cartridges. At that time, it was a rumor spread among the Hindu and Muslim sepoys that such cartridges which used for the infield rifle, these were covered with the fat from cow and pig. Cow is considered as a sacred in a Hindus and a pig as in Muslims. So it was as considered as a hurting of their religious sentiments. So in this process, the Mangal Pandey, which sacrificed himself as the first martyr of the revolt of 1857. Clear? So these were the causes, the main causes which responsible for the outbreak of revolt of 1857, the beginning of revolt of 1857. Some of the historians, they known as the revolt of 1857. Some of the historians, they consider revolt of 1857 as Sepoy Mutiny. Some of the historians, they consider that revolt of 1857 as Sepoy Mutiny. At the beginning, we discussed as it was the first war of independence, but some, they consider this as the Sepoy Mutiny. Why? Because clear? Sepoy Mutiny. Why? Because this revolt began with soldiers and a large number of soldiers which participated and died. These were basically as the sepoys, soldiers. Because the such soldiers which supported their rulers and sacrificed themselves for the motherland. So Mangal Pandey, it was hanged to the death for attacking his officers in a barrackpore. It may be as I ask you in an MCQ form, which place is known for the beginning of a revolt of 1857? It was a cantonment area of a barrackpore, where all the number of soldiers, they refused to use the greased cartridges, which were introduced by the Britishers in British Army. The revolt of 1857, it was started in an uncertain time in a different places. Uncertain, not on a particular time, it was as a started. On a different time periods, different dates, this revolt, it began in a different places. The revolt started at a barrackpore in a march, 29th of March in 1857, where the Mangal Pandey, a soldier in a British army, refused the use of greased cartridges and killed three British officials. In such avers, Britishers, they hanged Mangal Pandey. Mangal Pandey on 9th May 1857, revolt began in Meerut. Revolt started in Meerut on a 9th May. So due to the uncertain time periods, it's easy for the Britishers to control over the rebellions. If the revolt started on a same day, on a same period, then under such circumstances, it was not easy task for the Britishers to control over the rebellions. Due to the revolt started in an uncertain time periods, Britishers easily control over such rebellions in different time periods. Clear? In different time periods. Our next topic is that the rebellion spreads are the incidents associated with the revolt of 1857. Which of the incidents were associated with the revolt of 1857? Let's start from the first. So which of the states they participated in a revolt of 1857? Delhi. Delhi at that time, it was administered by the last Mughal emperor, Bahadur Shah Zafar. It was also as the leader of revolutionaries. All the rebellions, they followed the instructions given by the Mughal emperor Bahadur Shah Zafar II. In 1856, Lord Canning announced that Bahadur Shah Zafar, it will be as the last Mughal emperor. Clear? Last Mughal emperor. Afterwards, there will be no rule of the others. Clear? Clear? Then as the two sons of Bahadur Shah Zafar, these were assassinated by the Britishers in Red Fort. That part of a Red Fort is now presently known as the Khuni Darwaza. The southern gateway of Red Fort is now known as the Khuni Darwaza. So that's why the Bahadur Shah Zafar, it took part in a revolt of 1857. it took part in revolt of 1857. Clear? It took part in revolt of 1857. Second, Jhansi. Jhansi, second incident associated with the Jhansi. One of the greatest leaders of a revolt was Rani Lakshmi Bai. Rani Lakshmi Bai of Jhansi. She angered on Britishers to annex their territories in British Empire. To control over their territories of Jhansi in British Empire. She supported the rebels. Rani Lakshmi Bai supported the rebels, the British forces, using superior weapons. Second incident is associated with the Jhansi, in which as a Rani Lakshmi Bai, she strongly opposed Britishers, in which Britishers, they suppress Lakshmi Bai through the superior weapons, and Lakshmi Bai fled with rebels to join Tantya Tope. She fled from Jhansi and joined Tantya Tope, T-A-N-T-I-A, Tantya Tope, Tantya Tope in Gwalior, Rani Lakshmi Bai died in 1858. Rani Lakshmi Bai died in 1858. She died in 1858 with the Battle of Britishers. Clear? Now the third state as Kanpur, third state as Kanpur. In Kanpur, the revolt was led by Nana Sahib. Nana Sahib. Why? Because the pension of Nana Sahib, it was stopped by Lord Dalhousie on behalf of doctrine of lapse, because Nana Sahib, it was the adopted son of Peshwa Bajirao II. It was the adopted son of Peshwa Bajirao II. And on behalf of doctrine of lapse, it was not allowed to continue their rule over Kanpur. Then Britishers forcefully annexed their control over Kanpur. That's why Nana Sahib participated in revolt of 1857. Nana Sahib participated in revolt of 1857. Understood? Next place is Lucknow, which is associated with the Begum Hazrat Mahal. In Lucknow, Birjis Qadir, the son of Wajid Ali Shah, Wajid Ali Shah. Wajid Ali Shah was proclaimed the new Nawab. Was proclaimed the new Nawab. He acknowledged superiority of Bahadur Shah Zafar II. He acknowledged superiority of Bahadur Shah Zafar II. Zafar II and his mother Begum Hazrat Mahal. Begum Hazrat Mahal. His mother Begum Hazrat Mahal, MAHAL, took an active participation in uprising against the British. First off, next, as a Bareilly, presently it's in Uttar Pradesh, Bareilly, B-A-R-E-I-L-L-Y, Bareilly, I'm repeating again, B-A-R-E-I-L-L-Y, Bareilly, the sepoys of Bareilly participated in revolt on 31st May. On 31st May, the British officers fled for their lives. The revolt in Bareilly, handled by Khan Bahadur Khan. Now the last place remaining, Awadh, A-W-A-D-H, Awadh. Awadh took part in revolt of 1857 because of maladministration. Britishers blamed maladministration. Britishers blamed maladministration on Awadh. On such behalf, they annexed Awadh in British Empire. When this news spread among the soldiers, they started revolt. Those soldiers which belonged from the Awadh, they took part in a revolt of 1857. For injustice occurred with their territories. Territories means Awadh, which annexed by the Britishers on behalf of a maladministration. On such behalf, the Awadh occupied by Britishers under their control. Britishers under their control. Because of this act of Britishers, now the soldiers belonged from Awadh in British Army. In British Army, they started a revolt against of them. They started revolt against of Britishers. Clear? So these were the incidents which were responsible for the revolt. Revolt of 1857, it was basically occurred in a such number of areas. I'm repeating again, the Delhi, Jhansi, Kanpur, Lucknow, Bareilly, and Awadh. Bareilly and Awadh. All these areas, all such number of provinces directly took part in a revolt of 1857. Revolt of 1857. Clear? Revolt of 1857. Our next topic is the companies fight back. Companies fight back means as the how does the revolt of 1857 it became feel? The revolt of 1857, it was failed due to the certain conditions, due to the certain reasons. Yes, Rhythm? Rhythm Garg?
Sir, would
anybody having the, any of a doubts till there? Till there any doubts? Now next topic as the what were the reasons responsible for the failure of revolt of 1857 and how does the company fight back in revolt of 1857? Revolt of 1857. So what were the reasons responsible for them? First is weak leadership. Weak leadership. The revolt of 1857, it was failed. It was failed due to weak leadership. Weak leadership. The revolt of 1857 managed by the Bahadur Shah Zafar II, which was very old. It was old. Bahadur Shah Zafar, it was old and not efficient to administer the large territories. Large territories. So due to the weak leadership, the rebellions, they misguided and started revolt in uncertain time periods. In 1858, Britishers arrested the Bahadur Shah Zafar and sent him to the Rangoon. He sent towards the Rangoon, R-A-N-G-O-O-N, Rangoon, where he died. In 1858, Bahadur Shah Zafar II died. He died. His grave is present in a Rangoon, which now presently is known as a Yangon, Yangon. This is as the capital of Burma, capital of Myanmar. Which earlier known as Burma. Clear? Second, largely localized character. Second reason, largely localized character, largely localized character. The revolt of 1857, it was basically did not spread to the all parts of the country. Revolt of 1857 did not spread to all parts of the country. It was concentrated towards revolt of 1857 concentrated towards the limited number of provinces like Delhi, Jhansi, Lucknow, Kanpur, etc. The Bombay Presidency and Madras Presidency. The Bombay Presidency and Madras Presidency, they still remain as calm. Punjab, large provinces of Hyderabad, Mysore, Kashmir, and other states of Rajput Kingdom, did not participated in the revolt. Due to the concentration towards limited number of places, the revolt of 1857, it became fail. Now the third, lack of common ideals. This one also as the reason responsible for the failure of revolt of 1857. One of the reasons responsible for the failure